Hello everyone, myself Devisha, lecturer in chemistry, working in Indira Priyadarshini Government Degree College for Women, Nampally. We are discussing the coordination compounds. In this coordination compounds, the nomenclature of coordination compounds we are discussing today. And already we have discussed certain rules given by the IUPAC in order to name the complexes, right? So what are the rules? Once again, let us see. The first rule is the order of naming ions. That means in any coordination compounds, there will be a two parts are there. So in the two parts means one will be the cationic part and another one will be the anionic part. In this molecule also, this will be the cationic part and this will be the anionic part. So as per rule number one, first cation named first, then followed by the anion. And as per rule number two, so here we need to mention what is the number and names of the ligands first, then followed by the central metal cation during the naming of coordination sphere. And the third rule is, during the naming of ligands, here certain number means there are the four types of the ligands are there, like cationic ligands, anionic ligands, and neutral ligands and organic ligands. So if we see the cationic ligands and anionic ligands, cationic ligands always ends with the EM and anionic ligands are ends with the O, and neutral ligands are having a special names, like ammonia is called as NH3, ammonia is called as the amine group, carbon monoxide is called as the carbonyl group, NO is called as the nitrosyl, water is called as the aqua. So such as neutral ligands are having some special names in the coordination chemistry, and organic ligands are named as it is only. So if the more than one type of the ligand is there, then we have to name the ligands as per alphabetical order. The next one is the fifth rule is use of numerical prefixes. So there will be some types of the ligands are there. We already discussed in that simple ligands are there, such as monodentate ligands. They can form only one coordinate covalent bond with the central metal atom or ion. And there will be polydentate ligands are also there. These are also called as the chelating groups, right? And for simple ligands, we will use the simple terminology like bi, tri, tetra, tetra, penta, hexa, like this. And for polydentate ligands, if the ligands are having already the number in them, already number is there, so such kind of the ligands, we need to add the prefix, the numerical prefix is bis. If two ligands are present, bis we have to use, and if three such kind of ligands are there, then tris we have to use. The example for the ligands which are having already number in themselves is ethylene diamine. So in ethylene diamine already di is there, diamine. So two amine groups are there in the ethylene. So that is the reason the name itself, it is having already number, numerical prefix is there already. So such kind of the ligands we have to use the special numerical prefixes like bis, tris, tetrakis as per the number. So here central metal cation already three types of the complexes are there. One is the anionic complexes, cationic complexes. And anionic complexes always, in the anionic complexes, the name of the central metal cation ends with the 8, right? 8. And cationic complexes, if you see, there is no change in the name of the central metal ion. So what will be the name of this complex, this particular complex? Number one is ruled out here. Why? Because if there is any salt is there, then the cation given the name first, then followed by the anion as per the rule number one. But here there is no anion and no cation is there. Next, as per rule number two, we need to give the name for the cation, right?
name for the cation. So since it is a cationic complex only, and what are the next one is here the neutral ligand is there, and in the neutral ligand, first the names of the ligands given first, right, as per rule number 2. So, and how many ligands are there? Here 6 ligands are there. So, it starts with hexa, right? Hexa, simple numerical prefix I am using here for the monodentate ligand ammonia. And here ammonia is a neutral ligand, so hexaamine. And since it is a only one word, within one word we have to write, because it is a only the coordination sphere we are writing. So whatever the coordination sphere, whatever the elements are there, entities are there in the coordination sphere, we should write in the form of only one word. Hexaamine, right? And what is the central metal ion here? Cobalt. And this is a cationic complex. Here plus 3 is there, right? So cobalt is as it is only as per rule number 6. And cobalt is carrying, what is the charge it is carrying? Plus 3 oxidation state. How plus 3? Because ammonia is not carrying any charge, because it is a neutral ligand. So this charge is for this cobalt. If you calculate, also cobalt carries a plus 3 oxidation state, and we should write this oxidation state in the Roman numerals, in which should kept in the brackets here. And this is the ionic form. Since it is a cation, so hexaamine cobalt ion, right? Cobalt ion. So this is the name of this particular complex. And the second complex, let us take same, almost same complex, NH3 taken 5 times, and Cl2+. So this is the second complex I am taking, and for this complex now, this is also a cationic part, not a salt, okay? There is no anion is present. So similar way to the EPO compound, but here the two ligands are there. We are going to give the name of the cation only, and there at the first we have to give the names of the ligands. But here the two types of the ligands are there. So to which we need to first we have to take. So here the ammonia is means amine group, right? Amine is starting with the letter A, and this chloro group is starting with the letter C, right? So amine, chloro. So here amine, A comes first, right? So here I am writing amine. It is starting with the letter A, and chloro starting with the letter C. So which one will come first? This one will come first. So how many amine groups are there? 5 amine groups are there. Penta amine. See here, I am not writing 2 A's here. Pentamine. Okay. Pentamine. Okay. Next one is chloro anionic. Right. Chloro. And cobalt is a central metal cation, cobalt. And if you calculate the oxidation state of the cobalt, which comes 3 only, and ion. So let's once calculate the oxidation state of this particular complex, cobalt, amine, chloro, 2+, right? So here let us calculate the oxidation state of cobalt, and we don't know the oxidation state of cobalt. That is the reason I am taking X for the cobalt. And ammonia is a since neutral molecules, neutral ligands, and which carrying a 0 oxidation state, and Cl is carrying a -1. So X plus 0 into 5, it will be 0 only, right? So 5 into 0, 5 ammonia ligands are there, and which carries a 0, and only one anionic ligand is there, minus 1, okay, which is equal to plus 2, right? So x, 5 into 0 will be 0 only, and plus, okay, I will write, plus into minus, minus 1, which is equal to plus 2, and x, plus 0, minus 1. So, minus 1 is equal to plus 2, x is equal to this minus 1, comes this side, and it will become plus 1. So, x will be equal to plus 3. So, this is the oxidation state of cobalt, right? Cobalt. And let us take the another complex as an example, right? This is a salt. And the salt in which there are the two are there, because this one will be a cationic part. This one will be a cationic part and this one will be a anionic part. So, this is a not ion here like these two examples. So, now first we have to give the cation as per rule number 1. Now, second, as per rule number 2, while giving the name of the coordination sphere, we have to name the ligands first. And as per the rule number 3, here there is two types of the ligands are there. One is a neutral ligand. These are the neutral ligands. And these are the anionic ligands, and neutral ligands always are having the special names like amine and chloro. So anions ends with the O, and the neutral ligands are having a special name such as the amine. Okay, and as for the rule number 4, they are having a means they are named in the form of the alphabetical order. Right, alphabetical order, and already we have seen the above examples. This is the amine. Amine spelling is this A-M-M-I-N. So it is a starting with the letter A, and it is chloro group is starting with the letter C. Right, so first amine will come, and numerical prefixes we have to give here. Right, so as per all these rules given by the IUPAC, now we are going to name the complex here. So the first one is, this is, starts with the amine, right? A. So how many amines are there? 4 amines are there. So tetraamine, right? Tetraamine, dichloro, right? Tetraamine, dichloro, 2 chloro groups are there. So we should not give any space actually here. Diamine, tetrachloro, tetraamine, dichloro, cobalt, and here also the oxidation state is here, which is having a minus 1, minus 1 into 2, minus 2. And here plus 1 is there. This minus 2 will become plus 2, plus 2, plus 1. So, plus 3. Similar way to this one only, this calculation. We need to calculate this one also. And now this is the cationic part we have given. Now we have to give the anionic part. So what is the anion is present? Chloro group is present. But here we have to write chloride, because this is not a, means this chlorine is not inside the coordination sphere here. So whatever the chlorine group inside the coordination sphere, that ends with the chloro. Okay, anionic ligand ends with the chloro inside the coordination sphere, but this chlorine is outside the coordination sphere, that means in the ionic sphere. This is an ionizable ion, so this is a normal chloride only, and which will have to write as a chloride. Okay, and this complex will give on reaction with AgNO3 one mole of the silver chloride. It will give 1 mole of silver chloride. It will give, it will be precipitated. Okay, why? Because this chlorine is reacts with the this silver, but not this chlorine. Here if you react with this if this complex is supposed to react with the silver nitrate, it cannot give a any silver chloride. So silver chloride precipitate will not take place in this particular complex here. Here now this is also a salt, right? Salt. So salt is a combination of two ions. One is the cationic part and another one is the anionic part, right? So anion. So which one is the cation in this particular complex? This portion is the cation. Why? Because which carries a K plus, right? So when this salt is supposed to be dissociated in the presence of water, then the K plus ions will be separated out. So how many K plus ions are there? 3 K plus ions are there, and this portion will be the anionic part. So iron, Cn taken 6 times. Okay, now how many ions are separated out? 3 positive ions are separated out. So this will be 3 minus. Correct. So this is the actual means in its solution form. This will be the ionic state of this particular complex. So this is the cationic part and this is the anionic part. And as per our rule number 1, first we have to give the cation. So the cation is potassium here. And please remember, for potassium I am not using any numerical prefix, since here 3 potassium ions are there, but I am writing only potassium. I am not writing tripotassium. Okay, because it is in the ionizable sphere here, ionizable cation it is. So this nomenclature rules will not supposed to apply for the whatever the ligands which are present in the ionization sphere. Those only applicable for only the entities present in the coordination sphere only. And now potassium cation we have given name, and then we have to give the anionic part of this particular complex, right? So during the giving the name of this anionic part means coordination sphere, we have to give the ligands followed by the cation, central metal cation. So here the ligands are cyanide ligands are there, and total how many ligands? 6 cyanide ligands are there. So hexa, potassium, hexa, cyano, since these are the anionic ligands, they ends with the O, right? They ends with the O here. No need to highlight this one, cyano. Okay, just simply write potassium hexacyano. And this is a salt, right? This is a salt now. And in this salt, this is the anionic part of the salt. So this iron carries means ends with the 8. The suffix 8 we have to add. So ferrate. And what is the oxidation state of the this central metal cation here? That is plus 3. If you calculate the oxidation state of this particular complex, that it will give plus 3. So let us calculate the oxidation state of this particular complex also. So here for potassium, the positive charges are there, so it is a plus 1 into 3, right? 3 potassium ions which are carrying a plus 1 oxidation state. And plus this iron is we don't know we have to find out. So let us take X for the iron here. Okay, so this carrying a plus 1, this are carrying a minus 1. So minus, I am writing directly minus into minus 1 into 6 is equal to 0, right? 0, there is no number here. And here plus 1 into 3, that is the 3 plus x, minus 1 into 6, minus 6 is equal to 0. So here plus 3 is there, minus 6 is there. So x minus 3 will be equal to 0. X is equal to this minus 3. It comes this side, and by changing its convention, that is minus 2 plus 3. So iron here carrying the plus 3 oxidation state, right? And the next one is the, in this complex, chromium is a central metal cation, right? Chromium is a central metal cation, and here there are the two types of the ligands are there, and nitrate ligand is outside the coordination sphere, and inside the coordination sphere there is a sulfate group is there, right? Sulfate group is there, and this carries a this is again salt, like this particular molecule. And in this salt, what is the cation and what is the anion, we have to identify first. So we know this nitrate ion is the anion. This is the anion because which carries a minus 1 oxidation state. And here this one is a sulfate. This is a, this whole part, sulfate is also anionic ligand, but irrespective of that, this whole complex carries the plus 1 oxidation state, right? Plus 1 oxidation state. That is the reason, means after dissociation into the ions, this will carry minus 1 oxidation state, and this carries the plus 1 oxidation state. So that is the reason this is a cationic complex. And first we have to give the name of the cation first, right? As per the second rule. First rule. And here this is starting with the A, right? This is a neutral ligand, and this is starting with A, and this sulfate is starting with the S, right? So here this we have to write the name of the ligands first, in which ammonia first. So the name of this particular complex is tetramine. Four amines are there, no? So tetraamine sulfato, because it is the anionic ligand which ends with the O, right? Sulfato. What is the central metal cation here? Chromium. Chromium. Okay. What is the oxidation state? So sulfate carries the minus 2 oxidation state. And if you calculate, for chromium I am taking X, and this is a neutral ligand. For the neutral ligand, 0 oxidation state. And here X minus 2 I am directly taking into 4, because 1 is there, 1 sulfate is there, and is equal to minus here this is a minus 1 only, plus minus 1, okay, is equal to 0. So X minus 2 into 1 minus 2, and plus into minus minus 1 is equal to 0. So X minus 2 minus 1, that is a minus 3, is equal to 0. So X is equal to plus 3, right? Plus 3. So the oxidation state of chromium is plus 3. So we have to mention that is in the brackets, Roman numericals in the brackets. And then anion, we have to give the name. This is the nitrate, right? NO3, nitrate. So this is the name of this particular complex. In this complex, this is also a salt, and this will be cationic part, right? Potassium is a cation because it belongs to a S block elements and which carries a plus one oxidation state, alkali metals plus one oxidation state. And when it separate out, this will be a cation, and this will be in this particular salt, this will be a anion. And here this cation, two cations are there, but we are not mentioning the number of potassium ions here. So I am directly writing the potassium, okay, cation, okay, as per rule number one. First we have to give the name of the cation, then followed by the anion. And this is the anionic complex, and here how many ligands are there? So one type of the ligand, four ligands are there, four ligands, one type of the ligands only hydroxy groups only there. And in this hydroxy groups, this is anionic part, right, which carries the minus one oxidation state. So we have to give the name of this particular complex. So tetra, okay, tetra, because it is four is there, tetra hydroxo, DROXO, tetrahydroxo, zinc. So since it is a anionic portion, no, anionic complex, no, so anionic complex always ends with the aid, zincate, right, zincate. And let us see what is the oxidation state of the zinc here. Now for zinc I am taking X, and for potassium plus 1 is there, so plus 1 into 2, that is the plus 2 is for potassium, because two potassium ions are there, each carrying a plus 1 oxidation state. So it will be plus 2 plus X. X is for zinc. And how many ligands are there? Four ligands are there. So plus 4 into minus 1, which is equal to 0. So there is no number here, there is no charge, plus or minus charge is there. So 0, and plus 2, and plus X, plus 4 into minus 1, which will become plus into minus, minus 4 into 1, 4 is equal to 0. So here plus 2, minus 4, that will be, difference will be minus 2. X minus 2 is equal to 0. So X is equal to this minus 2 will become plus 2. So here what is the oxidation state of the zinc? Plus 2. So this is the complex. And I am going to take one more complex, that is the seventh complex, if any polydentate ligands are present. So what will be the name, means how to give the name of that particular complex, let us see now. So here I am taking the cobalt complex and ethylene diamine, taken three times, and three chloride ions are there. Next, this is the complex. How to give the name of this particular complex now? So here this ethylene diamine is, the EN is nothing but, what is the EN? EN is nothing but ethylene diamine, right? Diamine. So here this ethylene diamine, already it is having a the number in itself, right? So what is the structure of this ethylene diamine? CH2 NH2 is one end, and another NH2 is at another end. So the two amines are there, this is a one amine group, this is the second amine group. So the name itself, it is carrying that diamine. So because of this reason, we have to mention the numerical prefixes like bis, tris, tetrakis, like that, so on, because to mention the this type of the ligands here. So let us see now what is the complex. So in this complex again two parts are there, and after dissociation this will be the anionic part. And always remember, the anions are always we have to write on the right hand side, and the cations always write on the left hand side. So in the complex always this particular thing we have to remember, and the students mostly confuse here. And this is the cationic part now, right? Cationic part. And for this cationic part, we have to name, give the name first. And what is the name of this particular compound? Now, 3-ethylenediamines are there. For 3, what is the numerical prefix we have to use? Tris, right? Tris. Okay, and we have to add the name of ethylene diamine here in the brackets. Ethylene diamine bracket close, cobalt. Since it is a cationic complex, right? So I'm not writing 8 here. Okay, cobalt only. And what will be the oxidation state of cobalt? That is the +3 oxidation state after leaving this -1 chloride ions, right? So in the salt form it is a neutral one only, but salt electrically neutral one, but if it dissociates, the chlorides, 3 chloride ions separated out, so it carries the +3 and chloride. Okay, so I am not mentioning here the trichloride because this chlorine is outside the coordination sphere, right? So I am writing only chloride only. So tris, ethylene diamine, cobalt 3 chloride. This is the name of this particular complex. And let us see now other complexes this kind of complexes. This complex is a cationic part only, right? Cationic complex. And in which we have the two types of the ligands are there. One is the ethylene diamine and water. Both are the neutral ones only. So which carries the which does not carry any charge. So 0 oxidation state. Okay. And here 2 is there, here 2 is there. Okay, now 2 types of the ligands are there. First, as per rule number 2, we need to give the name of the ligands first. And this ethylene diamine is starting with the letter E. And water here, water. For water, we have to use the word aqua, right? Aqua. So it is starting with the A. And how many water are there? Water molecules are there. 2 water molecules are there. And what I am going to write now? Diaqua. Now here 2 ethylene diamines are there. As I told you earlier, ethylene diamine, the name itself already it is having a numerical prefix, right? So we should not use the di for ethylene diamine, and instead of using di, I am using bis. Bis is for 2. 2 ethylene diamines are there, and ethylene diamine. Okay, bis ethylene diamine chromium. The oxidation state of chromium is 3, and this is in the ionic state, cationic complex. So there are no anions are present in the ionization sphere. So this is a ion. The complex is an ion. So this is the complex, right? So I hope you understood how to give the nomenclature of this particular complexes. And the naming of polynuclear complexes. How to give the names of the polynuclear complexes? First, what are the polynuclear complexes are? Poly means what? Many. Many. So normally we will take the word means the meaning is many, but here we can take more than one, right? More than one. If more than one nuclear means here this nuclear is represents the central metal cation. So, if more than one central metal cations are present in the complexes, those complexes are called polynuclear complexes. And how to give the names of the polynuclear complexes is, there will be A means between A, any two metals. So, here I am taking the iron. So, they might be having ligands like this. So one ligand can form the bond between the two central metal atoms, and this kind of the ligands are called as the bridging ligands. These type of the ligands are called as the bridging ligands, and these ligands will form the bonds. Means at a time they can form the bonds with the two central metal atoms. So they are called as the bridging ligands, and they represents with the symbol means the prefix we have to use is mu, right? Mu. So mu hydroxo, like that. If it is a chloro group is there, and mu chloro, mu amido, mu amino, mu carbonyl. So like that we have to use the bridging ligands here. And for example, I'm taking one example so that you can understand betterly. The example is NH3 taken 5 times chromium, and hydroxy group is there, and same part I am taking this side also, NH3 taken 5 times, okay, and this is the coordination complex, and Cl5 is outside the coordination complex. So the as per IUPAC nomenclature, we have to follow all the rules. So as per the rule number 1, this is a salt, and in which this is a cationic portion and this is one is a anionic portion, right? This is the anion and this one is a cation. So first we have to name the cation first, and here the cation is complex ion only. And how to give the complex ion? First we have to give the names of the ligands first, then followed by the central metal cation. But here this is a bridging ligand is there, so this OH group is inserted between the two chromium central metal cation. So this is a bridging ligand here. And how to give the name of this particular complex? The simple way I am giving here, the first I am going to give this portion, okay, this portion I am going to give, that is pentamine, right? One type of the ligands only there, no? So pentamine and chromium, I'm giving pentamine chromium. And what is the oxidation state of chromium here? If you calculate, that is +3 it will be, okay, +3. Now we have to separate this hydroxy group because it is a bridging ligand with the hyphen symbol, and this is the hydroxy group, right? So this hydroxy group is carrying a -1, means anionic ligand it is. So this anionic ligand carries the minus one oxidation state, and since it is an anionic ligand, ends with O. So mu, right? So prefix we have to use mu again hyphen hydroxo. Hydroxo, okay. Again, what is there here? This portion we have to give now. Pentamine, okay. Pentamine, chromium, 3, and chloride is there, and irrespective of their number, I am just writing chloride because chloride is ionizable ions present in the ionization sphere. So chloride, the name of this particular complex is like this: pentamine chromium, this portion I have given, then mu hydroxo, again pentamine chromium, 3, chloride. So how to calculate the oxidation state of the central metal cation? Now here the central metal cation is same, this is for X and this is also X I am taking. Now these are the neutral ligands which carries a zero oxidation state, and these are also carries a zero oxidation state, and there are the 5 chloride ions are there, and each carries a minus one oxidation state. Now these are, since these are the zero, so 5 into 0, right? 5 into 0 plus this X I'm taking, and minus 1 I'm taking directly, minus 1 hydroxy group carries a minus 1 oxidation state, and plus X, okay? So X I'm taking, and plus 5 into 0 again plus the each chloride is carrying a minus 1, and there are the 5 chloride ions are there, and which is equal to 0 because this complex does not carry any charge here. So this will be 0, x here, so plus 2x, and minus 1, this minus 1 I am taking, and this is also 0, and plus into minus, minus 5 is equal to 0. So here the same type of the numerals are then minus 1, minus 5. So here, since this is a zeros only, I am removing these zeros here, and 2x minus 1 minus 5, that will become minus 6 is equal to 0. So 2x is equal to this minus 6 will become plus 6, and x is equal to plus 6 divided by 2. So this, the answer is 3. So here the x is equal to 3, and here also the x is equal to 3. So in this way we have to calculate the oxidation state of the central metal cation. Right, and let us see now the another example. This is the first example and second example here. Second example is, I'm giving to you NH3 taken 5 times cobalt, NH2 cobalt, NH3 taken 5 times NO3 taken 5 times, okay, and this NO3 is also carries the minus 1 oxidation state. And what will be the name of this particular complex now? So this complex is also very much similar to the above complex, only thing is we have changed the bridging ligand. Here the, instead of taking OH group, here we have taken amine group, right? Amine group. And this amine group is the bridging ligand between the two cobalt central metal cations. And here, instead of chromium, cobalt is there, and which is also carrying a plus 3 oxidation state in the similar manner. However, we have calculated the oxidation state here for the chromium. The similar manner we can calculate the oxidation state. And what will be the name of this complex? Pentamine, right? Pentamine, right? Cobalt. What is the oxidation state of cobalt? 3-mu. And this is now called as amide group. Amide. Okay. Now pentamine, cobalt, 3, and nitrate. Okay, this is the name of this particular complex. Okay, is this easy? So only thing is, we are keeping means in front of this bridging ligand, we are adding the prefix mu here. Okay, so mu we have to add, and if the bridging ligands are two are there, so how to give the name of the particular complex? If the two types of the bridging ligands are two or bridging ligands are there, so how to give the name of this particular complexes? Let us see now. So example I am taking here, the third example I am taking. NH3 taken 4 times, cobalt, here amide group, NH group is called as the amide, and if NH is there, that is called imidyl group. Okay, NO2. So there are the two types of the bridging ligands are there, cobalt and NH3 taken 4 times, so bracket closed, and nitrite, 4 ligands are there. Now what is the name of this complex? Very simple, similar to the above complexes only, but here the two ligands are there, two bridging ligands are there. We have to add these two bridging ligands in between the name. So this is the name of this particular complex is tetraamine cobalt. Similar way, we have to calculate the oxidation state, and the oxidation state of cobalt here 3, and this cobalt is also having a 3 oxidation state. And first I am writing this one, so mu amido. Okay, mu amido. And we have to write this one, so mu nitro. Mu nitro and tetraamine, okay, cobalt, the oxidation state of cobalt 3, nitrate. Okay, this is the name of complex. If the complex is having the polydentate ligands, then how to give the name of those complexes? Now let us see. So ethylene diamine, okay, taken 2 times, cobalt is a central metal complex, and here NH I am taking, and here OH I am taking. So this is called as the imido group now, and this is the hydroxyl group, and this side cobalt ethylene diamine taken 2 times. Okay, so this is the complex which is a cationic complex carrying a +3 oxidation state. So now what will be the name of this complex? So since it is a ethylene diamine, is having the name number itself, right? The name having the number itself. That is the reason for 2, I'm using bis, right? So bis ethylene diamine, ethylene diamine, bracket close, cobalt, cobalt, mu. First step one, we have to write imido, imido. Okay, then bottom one, we have to write mu, hydroxo, hydroxo. And again, we have to write the name of this particular one. So, bis ethylene diamine, ethylene diamine, bracket close, cobalt, cobalt, and the oxidation state is 3. So in brackets we have to write oxidation 3. Okay, so this is the name of this particular complex. Okay, so I hope you understood, and let us take one more example of this particular polydentate ligands. So the fifth one I am taking, so the fifth one is this is the oxygen carbon monoxide, so taken 3 times, iron, and here the bridging ligands are 3 ligands are there. So if the 3 bridging ligands are there, how to write? And same type of the bridging ligands, FeCO taken 3 times. Okay, so now 3 bridging ligands are there, and I'm going to write directly first this the name of this particular complex is tri. 3 are there, no? Tri mu carbonyl, right? 3 carbonyl, 3 groups are there, so bridging ligands are there. Carbonyl, and since here this part and this part both are similar, right? So we can also write the name like this. So bis, okay, bis. Why I am writing bis? This is for 2, mentioning 2. So this one part and this one part. So 2, because here tricarbonyl again it is there. That is the reason I am writing bis tricarbonyl. Tricarbonyl, okay. Iron, and since all the ligands are the neutral ligands only, which carries a 0 oxidation state, and here the complex is also does not having any charge, right? Any charge, it is a neutral complex only. So iron, the central metal cation, is also the 0 oxidation state. So this 0 oxidation state also we need to mention. So tri mu carbonyl, this tricarbonyl, we have to mention this in the brackets, and the iron, this iron is there. So 2 irons are there. This is for this whole part, this part as well as this part. So iron 0. So this is about the naming of this polydentate polynuclear complexes. And let us see now how to give the name of the complexes with ambidentate ligands. So ambidentate ligands, already we have discussed the examples of the ambidentate ligands and what are the ambidentate ligands also. So the ligands which are having a more than one donor atoms, more than one donor atoms, but they can form donor groups, but they can form only one bond at a time, but they can form only one bond with central metal atom or ion, with central metal cation. So these ligands are having a more than one donor atoms, but they can form only one bond with a central metal atom in one instance of time. So what are the examples of that ligands are? So thiocyanide group, right? So in the thiocyanide group, if through sulfur the bond is forming, this should be mentioned in the nomenclature also as per the IUPAC. Or if this nitrogen is forming a bond, so with the central metal cation, then this also means N we have to mention. So how, let us see now the example I am taking here. Example I am taking platinum thiocyanide taken 6 times. This is the complex, right? So for to give the name of this particular complex, again we have to use all the rules given by the IUPAC. So this is a potassium cationic part, and I am giving first the name of the cation, that is the potassium, irrespective of their number. And hexa, then the complex we have to give. So here the ligands, 6 ligands are there, so the prefix is the hexa. This is the thiocyanato group, right? Thiocyanato, hexa thio, because through S the bond is forming, through S the bond, this kind of bond is taking place here. This is the metal, is a platinum, and through sulfur the bond is taking place. So hexathiocyanato, because this is a pseudo halogen, right, which carries the -1 oxidation state, so anionic ligand. So thiocyanato ends with O and hyphen S. So through S the bond is forming, right? And this particular complex is the anionic part, because this is a cationic, this is the anionic. So anionic complex. So the name of central metal cation ends with the 8. So platinate, right? Platinate. And the oxidation state of this platinum here is +4. +4 is the oxidation state. So this is the name of this particular complex, right? And the other complex, let us take the another example is nitrato ligand. So ambidentate ligands are having another one, that is the nitrate ligand, and let us take the example of that particular complex. So here I am taking cobalt complex and NO2 taken 3 times and NH3 taken 3 times, okay, taken 3 times and bracket close. This is a neutral complex. And what is the name of the neutral complex? Let us write now. So here, since this is a nitrato ligand, and this nitrato ligand is also a ambidentate ligand. So how it will be? Just like a cyanato and thiocyanato isocyanato group, this is a isocyanato. For this we have to use isocyanato and hyphen N, okay, then the name of the metal, right? So for this we have to use like this. And this is a nitro group, either through oxygen it can form a bond, or through nitrogen also it can form a bond. So if it forms the bond with the nitrogen, so what will be the name of this particular compound? This is the nitrito, right? Nitrito. And this starting with the letter N, and ammonium is starting with the letter A. So the complex is starting with the triamine. Okay, trinitrito. So 3 for nitrito hyphen, and through nitrogen it is forming the bond, and cobalt, right? And here the oxidation state of the cobalt is 3. So if the bond is forming through oxygen, then the complex written will be cobalt ONO, taken 3 times, NH3 taken 3 times, this bracket close. So what is the name of this particular complex? Triamine, okay, and the trinitrito. Now through oxygen the bond is forming, through oxygen is a donor now for this particular compound. So trinitrito, okay, hyphen O, we have to write the capital letter of the element here, O, because through oxygen it is forming the bond, and cobalt oxidation state will not change, so it is also 3 only. So here also this is a nitrito group, and here also nitrito group. Only thing is, here the link between the central metal cation and the ligand is through N, and here through oxygen, and here through sulfur. If nitrogen is there, then it will be a isocyanate. So for this particular complex, if through nitrogen it is forming a bond, the complex will be written as K2, the same complex. So NCS taken 6 times, and the name of this complex will be potassium, and hexa isocyanato. Platinate. This one here we have to write the hyphen N. Okay, so potassium hexa isocyanato hyphen N platinate ion. So platinate, and oxidation state of platinum is 4. Okay. So this is the nomenclature of the coordination complexes. Thank you for watching.